such a marvelous thing. For someone so wretched, yet my soul, you have. to celebrate the homegoing service and the life of our friend, of our cousin, of our uncle, of our father, and indeed our brother, Cecil, Sidney, Alexander Cunningham. He has traveled apart that we all must, unless Christ returns and interrupts our travel. Because certainly the scripture says, for dust thou art, and to dust thou shalt return. That is the word of God. But with the same certainty, the scripture says that the dead in Christ shall rise first, and then we which remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. That is certainly the scripture of God. In this rest our hope, on this rested Brother Sidney's hope. So cheer up, family. This is the reason we can celebrate today. Brother Cecil is gone, and we grieve, family, and we must. But in the midst of it, our hope burns brightly, because we know we will see our brother again. He will come up for a certain king, better than he gone down. He will come up with eyes that function well, with legs and limbs that function well. He will have a new body, and he will have a new life. Oh, thank God for Jesus. I say, thank God for Jesus. This is the reason that we have hope, because of Jesus. No other reason. Because of his death and because of his blood, we have hope. So we have hope that we will see our brother again. So I ask us this morning, this afternoon, other than the Marine family, to stand to your feet as we sing the opening hymn. No other plea, after which you will have the invocation by Minister Darrell Ferguson.
Oh, Although, dear God, this may be a time of mourning for some and a time of sadness for some, God, we will lift up our hearts and our hands and we will give you praise. Above the fray, oh God, above all other things, God, we just say thank you and we give you all of the praise. So we invite your presence, dear Father. We invite your sweet, comforting hands to bless, to heal, to save souls, to minister, to touch this family in this special way. Bless the proceedings of this day. Bless the word. Bless the worship. Bless every aspect, oh God. And Father God, once again, we just say thanks. And we give you praise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. In and through the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Christ. The love flows. No matter what's going on in life, the love flows from salvation even to death. Oh, we give him praise in this house right now. We give him praise in this house right now. This is a time to worship. Do you understand that our brother has moved on, but he moved on in hope? So this is a time to worship and give God some praise in this house. I have to set the protocol in order here. And I say once again, welcome to all of you to the service today. We recognize the clergy that is here, that is headed by our national overseer, Bishop Ferguson, Sister Ferguson. I also recognize our Presbyter Emeritus, Bishop Thompson. I see Sister Thompson in the audience as well. And I see a cadre of bishops, also of our host, Bishop here, who's going to preach the word for us this morning, Bishop Hanna. And also the other bishop, Bishop Ferguson, my good friend, Bishop Peter, and all the other ministers that are in this house. We recognize you. The family is thankful that you're here, that you remember their friend, their family member. They are grateful that you remember Brother Cunningham. And we thank God for all of you in this house this morning, this afternoon. We're now going to have a scripture reading, our first scripture reading of the day. It will be Psalms 90, verses 1 to 12, and it will be read by the cousin of Brother Cunningham, Michael Cunningham.
Scripture reading is taken from the Old Testament, Psalm 90, beginning of verse 1 to 12. Lord, thou hast been a dwelling place for generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, forever thou hast formed the earth and the world. Even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art. Thou turnest man to destruction and sayest, return, ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday. When it is past, and as a watch. Thou carriest them away as to the flood. They are asleep in the morning. They are like grass which grows up. In the morning it flourishes and grows up. In the evening it is cut down and buried. For we are consumed by thy anger, and by thy wrath out of trouble. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is full. The days of our years are 80 years and 10. And if by reason of strength they are 84 years. Yet it is a strength, labor, and sorrow. For it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy will, so is thy law. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Heaven's word, we need God's word.
It's been great. I also want to recognize and extend my apologies. We're so very happy to have the minister agriculture here with us today. We're happy to see you today in the house. Now we can have a time of worship. Turn it over to the praise team.
Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. If you're a conqueror, I want you to stand here and give God a conquering praise. I believe I see some conquering ones in the house, because even over death, we have victory. We can rejoice tonight, this morning, in hope, because Brother Cunningham has gone on to his reward. And if we prove faithful, we're going to see him again. I don't know about you, but I feel like pressing my wish, because we have a hope that we are going to a place where the soul of man never dies. Anybody feel like singing to Jesus? You're talking about a good time, we're talking about up in heaven. We're here to rejoice in the hope of the believer, where the soul
persons. One is Reverend Samuel Sanders, who is a friend. And then Reverend Curves, a cousin, and we also have a tribute from an interested cousin. So I ask you to come in that order and to make your expression.